What up, second grade? It's Miss Carl here. Great to see you all back today. We're going to be going over prefixes and suffixes. So let's recall, a prefix is a little part that comes before our main word or our root word, and then a suffix comes at the end of our main word or root word. So let's look at a couple examples of these. So this top word says hopeless. So we have our main root word hope here, and then we have our suffix less, which means without. So if you're hopeless, that means you're without hope. Next, we have the word rewrite, and we can see our root word right here. And then we have the prefix re in the front. Well, our prefix re means to do again. So if rewrite, that means to write again, because we have that prefix re there. Our next word is useful. We have our root word use and then the suffix full. The suffix full means full of, so full of use. That's what the word useful means. Next, we have unhappy. So we have our root word happy, and we have un in front of it, which means not. So that means not happy. If someone's unhappy, they are not happy. And then our last word here is distrust. So we have our root word trust, and we have the prefix dis in front of it, which means the opposite of. So this means the opposite of trust. So prefixes and suffixes are important because there might be a word that we don't know, but if we can identify that prefix or suffix in that word, that can help us understand the meaning. Like unhappy, we see that prefix un in the front, we see that root word happy. We know un means not, so that helps us know not happy. So we're gonna go ahead and do a little bit of practice with these. So we kind of have a tic-tac-toe game here. So the directions say, read each definition and answer choice. Drag the word that matches the definition to the line. Then place your X for tic-tac-toe. So we're going to be playing against the computer as we do tic-tac-toe. But the main thing I want to focus on is figuring out what word matches these definitions. So to draw again. Well, I know that the prefix re means again. So if I want to draw again, that means you need to redraw.
Good job.
All right, let's go ahead and put our X on the board. See where the computer puts their O. All right, to use again. Well, we know again gives us that prefix re. If I want to use it again, I want to reuse.
Good job.
All right, let's put our X here, see if we can get three in a row. Our next one is to write again. Well, again tells us that prefix re, and then we have our root word write. So rewrite.
Good job.
And we'll go ahead and put, we won. All right, let's try our next one. So full of cheer. Well, we know the suffix full means full of. So if you're full of cheer, we have that root word cheer there. I want you to go ahead, take your pointer finger, and I want you to, don't actually touch your screen, but point to the word that you think means full of cheer. Go ahead. So you should have pointed it to cheerful, full of cheer.
Great job.
Full of fear. So again, the suffix F-U-L gives us that full. So which word is full of fear? Go ahead and again, point to the answer. You should have pointed to fearful, full of fear.
Good job.
Full of peace. So again, the suffix F-U-L gives us full of that meaning. So it's full of peace. Go ahead and point to our answer. Yeah, you should have pointed to peaceful.
Fantastic.
All right, our next one, without a shape. So our suffix less means without. So without a shape, what's that root word going to be? Go ahead and point to our answer. You should have pointed to shapeless, right? Without a shape.
Great job.
Without pain, again, L-E-S-S, that suffix gives us without the meaning. So if you're without pain, what word would we have? Our root word is pain there. Go ahead and point. Yeah, painless.
Great job.
We're killing this tic-tac-toe game. Without harm. So again, that L-E-S-S suffix tells us without. So without harm, what would our word be? Go ahead and point to it. Good. So you should have pointed to harmless.
Good job.
All right, next one. So, ooh, these are getting trickier. So I want you to try to remember which one means the opposite. It's a prefix. Does un or dis mean opposite? I want you to think for a second. So the opposite of to like. So that means if the opposite of like is to not like somebody. So what word do you think? Do you think it's dislike or unlike? What do we think? I want you to go ahead and point to your answer. What do you think? So it should be dislike. Dis is our prefix. That means the opposite of. So the opposite of like is dislike.
Fantastic.
Not cooked. So what prefix means not? And then our root word would be cooked. So go ahead. I want you to point to what you think our answer is. So you should have pointed to uncooked because our prefix un means not. And then we have our root word cooked.
Good job.
Not sure. So again, what prefix means not? And then we have our root word sure. What word? Go ahead and point to our answer. Yeah, you should have pointed to unsure. You're not sure.
Good job.
All right, not tied. So again, what's our prefix that means not? And then we have tied. Go ahead and point. What do you think? So you should have pointed to untied. That means not tied. Un gives us not.
Great job.
The opposite of to trust. So what prefix means the opposite of? Then we have our root word trust there. So if you have the opposite of trust, the opposite to trust, what do we have? Go ahead and point to our answer. Good, you should have pointed to distrust, the opposite of trust.
Good job.
And we won. All right, second grade, that was awesome. So remember, prefix can be added to the beginning when a suffix can be added to an end. Real quick, some common prefixes that we talked about was re, again, un, which means not, and dis, which means the opposite of. And then two suffixes that we practiced was less, which means without, and then full, which means full of. So those are important to remember and practice. Great job, second grade. See you next time.